Hey, I'm Lucas Kwiatkowski, founder of Nomadz, hands-on and advanced PPC. And I'm really excited to bring another new tool to you guys, Data Dive. So this is the layout of Data Dive. If you're not familiar with it, I think a lot of you are, because I was actually talking with Brandon Young last week, and I know that this is his tool, obviously, and he trains all of you with this tool and Scale Insights. So we know our audience is a lot of people who are using Scale Insights, because that's the software that we use to run a lot of our PPC. And this is the other tool that we use daily to get all of the data to feed into Scale Insights. All right. So if you guys are still looking for what tools to use, and you know I don't promote a lot, but these two should be all that you need: Data Dive and Scale Insights. And I hope that these kind of two videos together will help to get you more efficient at these tools, and show you just kind of an intro to them and how our team is using them and how you guys can get better with them. So this is, again, the layout, and I'm gonna get here in a minute, but if you are new to this tool, I wanna show you how to get here and how to do what we call a dive. Most importantly, Data Dive is a extension of Helium 10. So you need Helium 10 to do this, and then Data Dive is an extension of that. So what you do is you just type in a seed keyword. So I thought it's summer. Thinking of a good example, I went with picnic blankets, and I went with picnic blankets waterproof. For when you do a dive, you always want to be a little more specific and see how you're looking at a niche. You're really diving deep into a niche. So if I just do picnic blankets, I'm going to get ones that are large and waterproof and white and red and blue and all of this stuff. But if I'm selling a waterproof picnic blanket, I want to see how I'm comparing to the other guys that are ranking well. So that's what I went with. And there's two ways to get to this fancy page that I have up here. You go to Helium 10, you click on your Helium 10 extension, and you'll do the X-ray button. You can click dive right away. All right, you can click dive. One more thing here is we do like to filter out the sponsored products, because we're looking, because we wanna see the ones that are ranking well organically. So you can find a keyword and click dive, and you're going to get to that page. Another new thing that they came out with is an Asin Tray. So you can see here I already have a few on my tray. I picked these specifically. If I want to go down this list and add them, it's saying, okay, this is added to your tray, add to your tray. I can exit out of this page, and I can go into search results, and I can say add to tray. Boom. So now I have an Asin Tray. I click on my Data Dive Asin Tray, and I click search on Amazon. What this is gonna do a custom search for every ASIN I added to the tray. Now, I go to Helium 10, I click that X-ray. Again, it has only the ones I selected. I selected 9. But you need to do a minimum of 10, max of 20, so I can click dive on all the ones I selected. All right, so either way you slice it, you're gonna get there eventually. But most important thing, you need to select your ASIN in a dive. You need to select your ASIN in a dive. So for this example, I'm going to say, and I know I'm jumping around a lot here, but I'm going to stay on this page now. For this example, I'm going to say that we are this seller right here. We are number 2 in the category, okay? And we're trying to see what the Scuttle's listing. We're trying to see what they're doing. What keywords are they ranking on? How can we improve our PPC, our keywords, to maybe steal the bestseller from them? So for this example, we are this number 2 guy. But it's very, very important that you always select your own ASIN in a dive, because that's the whole point of this, is to compare your ASIN to the bestseller and to the other competitors. Now, I'm going to do a whole kind of mini series here to start on all of these little tabs on Data Dive and how to use them. For now, I'm just going to stick to the first one, that is the master keywords list, okay? So there's a lot of cool stuff in here. It shows your review count. It shows you listing age, right? So this Scuttle's guy has been there for 4 years, and these guys are already number 2, and they've been there for 6 months. So they're climbing up the listings pretty up the rankings pretty quickly right now. But this is the meat that we want to look at. So I'm going to expand this, so that we're only looking at these two and really get you guys to lock in on this here. Now, We are PY super mode. That's our ace in this example. We are looking at what Scuttles is doing. So I want to see right away, what keywords are they ranking on that we're not ranking on, that we're relevant for? So this first one, and also, guys, why I like Data Dive, I just scroll to the bottom of the keyword list. So it's not an overwhelming amount of data. I just scroll to the bottom, and you can put in minimum search volumes here or minimum relevancy. So you keep your list very tight because you don't want to go too crazy with this. You want to say, okay, what 20 keywords are they ranking on that I can improve my ranking on? That's it. Keep it simple. So I scroll up here, and the very first keyword that they're ranking on that has the highest search volume, highest relevancy, is outdoor picnic blanket. They're one and we're three. Now, you don't want to get too carried away with this. We rank number three organically for this. I'm going to leave that one alone. I'm going to say, you know what? They're one, they're three. I'm pretty happy with that. But this second one, picnic blankets waterproof, right? That's the whole reason I started this dive. We are ranked 19 for this keyword. They are ranked one. So right away, I want to open up their listing and my listing and see, they don't even have waterproof in their title, right? They have water resistant, and we do have waterproof in our title. So we're already ahead of them there where we have it in our title, but maybe we need to move it even up in our title and do an exact phrase for it. So maybe we want to change our title to picnic blankets waterproof instead of the phrase picnic blankets extra large. That's the first way you need to think about this. Remember, PPC is the final step in the game, okay? So I'm coming here and I'm looking for all of these ones that they rank number one and we're like past number 10. So again, waterproof, blanket picnic, a different order of it. It looks like these guys, like we are ranked number 141 for picnic rug. Clearly, we have never been on that keyword. It is probably not in our SEO at all. And they are crushing us on that keyword. Number 71, lawn blanket, right? So all of these words where sometimes if you get tunnel vision on just the word picnic blanket and anything that's associated with it, you are missing out on all of these other words that your competitors are just dominating you for. So even if I look at number three here, I look at number three in the category and say, okay, what are they ranking for that they're beating us for? Washable picnic blanket. They're killing both of us. Do they say washable somewhere? They don't. Yeah, they do right in the title. Machine washable. Right? So this is all the stuff you need to think about. You need to use this list to very carefully pick your battles. And you need to say, okay, which one of these is most relevant for us? Is it washable? Is it large? Or is it another word that we want to go after for picnic blanket? But this gives you such clear data on what they're doing and what you should be doing to build your master keyword list. Okay? And obviously, guys, you can export this. Right? So you can export this. You can build your list. And in the next video, what I'm going to do here is continue to build this list and show you, because what you want to do is you can start to exclude words from this. So if I scroll down here and I say, you know what? I actually don't want blue. I don't want Pendleton is a branded search term. Padded, I'm not padded. So what you can do is you start to select these and you click exclude. So you start excluding keywords from this list and the list gets smaller and smaller. And that's what you want. You want a very small targeted keyword list. And if I'm calling this picnic blanket waterproof, maybe I only want waterproof keywords in here. So maybe I exclude everything else except water resistant and waterproof, and then I exclude that, and then boom, I'm off the races.